just mugging, mugging, and exam vomiting, then forgetting everything.
Yeah,
without
we
knowing
have
the
agreed that there are improvements in books, there are improvements in facilities, we have improvements in technology, we have improved a lot in science, mathematics, medical science, and also social sciences, though not pointed out. So we have lots of improvements. It makes us feel that the standards have not fallen because of the improvements. But there must have been something which made the critics to say that the standards have fallen. What should have been the reason?
Madam, I better tell that education standards as a whole did not fall down. But when we take like India was the country which introduced zero to the world.
Yeah.
Zero, without zero, nothing would have been possible.
Yes.
And Sushruta was the father of plastic surgery, which was in ancient, in just almost a century time. The thing is, we had three universities before 5th century itself. Means we had a terrible knowledge availability source.
So you
everything.
Mean to say that there is a decline in education?
Not exactly.
Standards is too big a generalization, like too sweeping a generalization.
Yeah.
In fact, we have improvements. That's what is it?
Yeah, I would like to say that when we compare that, the proportional growth is not that correct. Like when we see that and now,
proportionally
we have not that much.
Not
we have not increased.
Right.
Madam, I have a point to share with you. Actually, there is no uniformity in the education, whether at school level or at college level or university level.
Curriculum,
uniform
standards.
Yeah, that is leading to the variations at different levels, and that's also reflecting in the standards.
Facilities also?
Yes, in terms of facilities, in terms of positions, or in terms of in many respects, we see lot of differences. If we take the schools, we see the public schools, we see the international schools, we see the normal schools, we see the central schools. Like that, when there are these different schools, we are finding different standards. Not only that, if we see the expenditure that is spent on student also by the parents, this is varying significantly.
So you mean to say that there is a lot of imbalance, right? Imbalance is there. It is going to be one of the big problems that we are facing. Okay, now looking at the new education policy introduced by Government of India, which aims at raising the standards of raising standards in education and also raising the quality of education, we are agreed now that to say that the educational standards have fallen is not a correct statement, right? Number one. Then the education policy also aims at realizing 100% participation, by which we mean that the students' enrollment at the elementary stage should be very high. Very high means 100% participation, and also there should be gender equality in respect of enrollment, in respect of education. So looking at elementary education and secondary education, what do you think of the position?
One thing, in maintaining uniformity is one thing that can solve the problem.
Okay.
Not only that, educational institutions working with commitment means the government, whether it is central government or state government, I personally feel the education, instead of leaving to the states, the center takes over the education entirely, and if it can maintain the education sector completely with uniformity, whether it is school education or whether it is college and university education.
Maintenance of uniformity is very essential.
Yeah, maintenance of the uniformity, I feel, is very essential. Otherwise, we see the contrast. On one hand, a university student is also unable to write a letter in English. And contrary to that, a third class student in the school is also speaking English so fluently, and we can see this difference. But if all students are provided the same facilities, then there may not be such.
Apart from maintaining maintaining uniformity and having commitment, Bhumika, what more measures would you suggest? Bhavika, what more measures would you suggest?
I agree with Sir's point. The thing is, uniformity as we have.
Apart from those, what do you suggest? Uniformity and commitment.
Hmm.
Do you suggest any changes in curriculum or teaching modules?
Teaching modules, where it lies is, the teaching modules lies in the private sector. The private sector teaching modules is separate and the government sector. The student standards lies in this. As we see in the government sector, the curriculum is different, and private sector, the curriculum is different. So the thing is, the private students, with they have admission into the private schools or colleges, the thing, they have lots of curriculum, and they are strict to that, and they are forcing this, the teaching staff and all, they are forcing them to do this thing or not. Government, what the government sector is doing is, they'll just implement, that's it. It goes,
if it is implemented, the things must have been very nice.
Okay.
Murthy, do you find any problems in the implementation of the policy?
Yeah, first of all, madam, one of the main problem why children are not being educated, if you say. Like, I have come to know some things, like, that parents also telling, like, nowadays, who will get a job? After, if you study, what job will you get? Unless I invest my son in agriculture, he'll learn some work. Afterwards, he'll be productive. Now, government is not able to give a guarantee that a person who is studying will get a job. If they have that job, something like, there is a hope, something like that. If it is only for the those who are rich and all, the poor will definitely, it's a setback for them. After all, if the person studies and goes, and when he becomes big, he doesn't know even the job, he doesn't get a job, and even he doesn't know how to work. Like, if he was employed earlier, that's the way why child labor is more. Because the parents are just thinking that, if at all I spend all the money on him, invest all the time on him, and if he studies, what is the guarantee that he's going to get a job?
So would you suggest increasing employment-oriented educational institutions, like professional education?
I mean, I didn't get more,
no, would you suggest an increase in the number of professional educational institutions to facilitate?
So in urban areas, what had happened is, we have very much private schools or corporate colleges. The things they teach to the students are, they are also, we can't say that they are spoon feeding, but the way they teach the students or the way they hold all the programs is such a type like that. They are not used to all the other such things. If you have a particular subject, if we take particular subject as science, and in science, if we take only a lesson called wave. So the thing the private colleges or schools, they do is, the wave subject, they'll be giving all the points, each and every point they will be giving one by one. The student is used to that point.
We have facilities, but I think you feel that the facilities should reach up to the grassroots level, is it?
Yes.
Internet facility is there, but it is not available to all. So it should be reaching to the needy and also to the grassroots level. Bhavika, would you have any more suggestions?
Yes. As sir told, if I continue that topic, the thing is, we have lots of facilities. We need to improve the facilities. That is the one topic. And the other thing is the utility of the facilities. The person who is interested, he will only approach and see all the things, what are the facilities given. Other than that, the person who is not interested, what will be the criteria to improve the knowledge or improve the...
To facilitate more educational opportunities, universities have come forward with the distance educational programs. And also there are universities which are started especially to provide the distance education. Do you feel that distance education is of use and really? And do you feel there is a criticism that distance education has not been useful? How do you look at it, Balasan?
Here also what I would say is that we should maintain the quality. In distance education, if we are meant for giving the certificates, will not have any meaning, just other than giving the certificates. But in distance education also, if we can stress on the standards, if we can maintain the quality, if we see the change, the desired change in the student, whether it is at graduation level or post-graduation level, even at research. Nowadays, some universities are also offering MPhil and PhD courses. If these MPhil and PhD courses are just for collecting money and giving the certificates, it really leads to the deterioration of educational standards. But at the same time, if the concerned faculty members, if they emphasize on the standards and if they train the students even in distance mode in such a manner that certain quality is maintained, really it is very much useful. In fact, distance education is providing a lot of opportunity to so many people, those who could not do the graduation, those who could not do the post-graduation, such aspiring candidates, they could complete their education through distance mode and they excelled. They could build very good care.
But there is evidence to prove that through distance education, wonderful PhD dissertations have come up, which could be compared with those of the central universities.